Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. Experiments can be dangerous. If you are a child, never do experiments unless your parent, guardian, or adult educator says it's all right and is there with you the whole time. There's a part of this video in which some colors flicker as they are spun on a disc. Viewers who are sensitive to that should have an adult screen this to be sure it's acceptable for that viewer. Before watching this video, we suggest that you first watch the video introducing light. When we paint a picture, we start with a blank piece of paper that add different colors of paint. Almost always, that blank piece of paper is white, so it's natural to think of white as meaning there's no color. In contrast to having no colors, when we mix many paints in the same area, we get a dark color. Given these experiences, many people find it hard to believe that the color of light that we call white is full of other colors, rather than being blank and empty of color. In this video, we'd like to demonstrate some experiments and observations that support the theory that white light contains all colors of light. To do that, we'll introduce what's meant by the term white light versus other colors of light, how Isaac Newton disproved a wrong theory about the colors of light, what colors are in the visible light spectrum, and how prisms and water droplets can separate white light. First, let's discuss the terms for the colors of light. This rainbow shows very vivid and distinct colors of light, including red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and violet. In contrast, an ordinary flashlight and lamp appear to be shining white light. It looks like the color white among our paints. When we shine flashlights at white paper, we can tell what color is coming from the flashlight. We name the light's color according to the color we see on white paper. Likewise, although it would be dangerous to look at the sun directly, since white paper appears white outside, we say that the sun makes white light. Next, we'll introduce one of Isaac Newton's most famous experiments on light. When Newton was studying nature about 400 years ago, many people believed that white light was like a blank piece of white paper. They thought that prisms and crystals could add all the colors of the rainbow to the light as a beam passed through them. Newton thought this theory was wrong, and he wanted to disprove it. Using only two prisms and simple supplies, Newton disproved that theory. Can you think of the experiment's design? Newton used two prisms, but one of them he partially shielded so only a narrow beam of light could enter it. To make things simple, we've shielded this prism by covering one side with cardboard, except for a narrow opening. Even with one side almost totally covered, the prism still works because when white light enters, a full spectrum of colors exits. This is our experiment's setup. We put the uncovered prism upside down, so the spectrum of colors would hit the side of a building. We held a board near the wall to block direct sunlight on the wall, so that there'd be a shadow on the wall to make the colors easier to see. The views you'll see are taken by a camera placed behind the prism and aimed at the wall. Here's what the experimental setup looks like from the camera's viewpoint. We're holding the partially covered prism close to the wall, so only one color enters that prism at a time. Since light that exits a prism does so at a steep angle, the exiting light shines on the wall below the level of the prism we're holding. As Newton discovered, we find that if only blue light enters the prism, then only blue light exits the prism. If only green light enters the prism, then only green light exits the prism. And if only red light enters the prism, then only red light exits the prism. Newton's experiment helped to disprove the popular theory that a prism adds the full colors of the rainbow to whatever light passes through that prism. Instead, it appears that prisms only transmit whatever color enters them. Although there were no lasers around when Newton lived, we can use them to show that, just as he described, whatever color or colors go into a prism is the same color that comes out. We can also see that the prism bends light in a process called refraction. Water can also do this, as we demonstrated in the prior video. Newton concluded that what we perceive as white light is really the combination of all colors of light, and that a prism can separate the light so we can see them as distinct colors. Next, we'll introduce the full colors of the light spectrum. In the prior video, we learned that visible light is part of the electromagnetic spectrum. And like all forms of electromagnetic radiation, visible light has a range of wavelengths. When we zoom into the visible light part of the electromagnetic spectrum, we see that the wavelengths range from about 380 nanometers to 750 nanometers, That means there are about 400 distinct colors of light that humans can see. The lasers we're using in this video have the wavelengths we've highlighted inside the white rectangles. Their colors are very close to those exact values. Typically, the wavelength values are written on the lasers. Please note that there are two colors missing from this display, the colors black and white. We normally find these among any paint set, but they do not exist as specific colors for light. There's no such thing as a visible light color that's black. When we look into outer space and see black between the stars, we are noting the absence of any light. There's also no color in the spectrum that is white. So then, why do we see white light? To answer that question, let's do a few experiments. We printed this disc with 7 different colored wedges, but there's no white on the disc. When we spin this fast, our brains and cameras perceive the collection of multiple colors in one place as a white color. Our perception is wrong because our cameras and brains are unable to keep the colors distinct when they're all in the same place and at the same time. Here's a second experiment. We'll shine multiple distinct colors of light at the same area. As we add color to that area, our brains perceive this as the color white. Our brains can get the perception of white light when just 3 colors, which are red, green, and blue, are shined at our eyes at the same time. This is how LCD monitors on our screens work. This is an extreme close-up of LCD lights. In reality, each of these are much smaller than the tip of a safety pin. Next, we'll discuss how prisms and water mist can separate white light into many colors. If you've ever seen a double rainbow, you may have noticed that the colors are in the same sequence, except reversed. For example, one edge is red, the other edge is violet, and green is near the middle. This sequence pattern is the same we see with prisms. Instead of shining white light through this prism, which would contain about 400 unique colors of light, we'll shine just red, green, and violet. They enter at exactly the same angle and at the same level on the prism. What pattern do you think we'll see on the wall? The colors are in a familiar order. Red and violet are on the top or bottom, and green is at a middle level. Even though each color entered the prism at the same angle and height, they exited at a slightly different angle because they refract by different angles. Now, let's see how water affects the refraction angles of these 3 colors. We've set the lasers at the same angle, and their light is entering the water at the same level. Again, we see a familiar pattern with red or violet on the top or bottom, and green is between them. This tank of water is like a droplet of water and mist, since both can refract any light that enters them. And because each wavelength of light has a different angle of refraction, the water droplets can separate any white light passing through them. So we no longer see white light and instead see each individual color. Here's a summary of the topic we just covered. Please pause the video to read this if you wish. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.